back to another part of Gulag, or another session of Gulag, to play through Battlefield 1 War Stories. On this one, we're playing Battlefield 1 again, and again we're playing the War Stories campaign. Oh wait, should I have both? I wonder if they're going to add more campaigns other than the War Stories. Because as you can see, it has campaign, or has multiplayer, and campaign. Which campaign is also War Stories, so I might have to do it just even with my title, which, by the way, speaking of titles, or speaking of previous videos, I do apologize for the last session. I don't know what happened to it. It must be some apology bug, which happens every now and then with any recording software, really, but I think that happened to me before with the apology, and it just happens randomly, and it sucks. I hope it was okay. I kind of want to do a do-over just to see, you know, just to have it all right on camera. I don't really have time for that tonight. So let's go straight to Mud and Blood, which I decided I will be doing the, I'll be doing the leapfrogging method. Well, also thought I had my, I was not ready. I thought I was ready. I was not ready. I mean, I've been in a rush because I almost fell asleep like 3 minutes ago. But then Grunts came up with me, so I had to do it, and I had to record this, so yeah. Anyway, so, yeah, let's do... I mean, the audio was there, it was just delayed by a couple seconds, it was really odd. Anyway, so, Through Mud and Blood. The British Mark V tank is an armored beast designed for a single purpose, shattering enemy lines.
My granddad fought in the Civil War. Before I left, he told me what it takes to stay alive, but nothing could have prepared me for what I saw. New machines of war, like the tank, could sometimes change the battlefield overnight. Luckily, they were mostly on our side. Mostly.
Okay, so it zooms in even more for a better view. He's a tank crewman, or at the very least, tank commander at the very most. We got easy, normal, hard. Oh. That's an interesting system. You don't actually use the left stick, you just press Y. Oh, that reminds me real quick. Before we get into battle, I want to show you some adjustments I made to the options. As well as I'm level 3 now. And by the way, there's also, man, battle packs you have over here, pass skip battle packs, there's puzzles where you got, basically these are your unlockable weapons that you unlock via getting, well, puzzle pieces in the battle packs. And then inventory, what battle pack items you have. Which I got the MB18 off camera, or on camera, but that was gameplay. Which I'll link in the description to the gameplay series. Which I had already linked in the description, the gameplay series to this. Anyway, so if I were to hit start? No. Back? No. Where is options? Oh, right there. I was blind. I'm used to having to look for it in an alpha game. I'm used to just saying star or something. Alright, so for one, I did nothing with this screen, I don't think. Oh, yes, this is my sensitivity for right now. It is 35. That's not gonna help. in there somewhere. I do have the assist turn. I do have the aim assist turned off. I'm on a 90 field of view. These aim assists are turned off. No, yeah, turn that on. I'm gonna need it. I think that's the feature I've been wanting in Battlefield game for so long. Oh, here's the front of you right there. All right. Oh, there's the screen width. I was looking for that. That's hidden. It's hidden to all ends. Minimize it a couple just to make it better. Of course, you can't see me minimizing it, but I did. That is hidden to all ends of the earth. Wow. Well, I think it's good now. Good. Now we can. Now we can proceed.
My granddad fought in the Civil War. Before I left, he told me what it takes to stay alive, but nothing could have prepared me for what I saw. New machines of war, like the tank, could sometimes change the battlefield overnight. Luckily, they were mostly on our side. Mostly.
You remember this takes place, you know, this is taking place in 1918? So, yeah, it's basically equivalent of today having your grandfather or your grandfather fight in World War II or Vietnam, mostly Vietnam these days. Like, my grandfather was at Vietnam during the Vietnam War. He went to Saigon. He was basically like a quartermaster supply sergeant for the Navy. He served on support ships, like minesweepers, you know, refueling ships, stuff like that. So, yeah. And he was there for, like, either a couple months or 2 years. I forgot which. But, yeah. But anyway, so, yeah, the Civil War, Vietnam, and World War One are all very similar in terms of their heavy costs in life. Or at least the Merc, anyway. And, you know, the Civil War is the granddaddy of modern warfare. Things that we take for granted today, and in World War II, and in World War I, were first introduced in the American Civil War. Like, for instance, ironclads. Ships clad in iron. And turrets on ships. Because the CSS Virginia was the first vessel clad in iron, which all ships are today, and the USS Monitor was the first ship to have a turret on it, with two guns, and it was really low profile too. There's also the Gatling gun, there's also air technology with hot air balloons that the Union was using, and the Gatling gun was both rifled guns. By the way, so yeah, when I think of, like, when I look at the material for Battlefield 1, let's say, like, the dawn or pre-dawn before, the pre-dawn of modern warfare, I'm like, what does it make the Civil War, what does it make the American Civil War? The Knights? The day before? By the way, so, yeah, over the top. Number one, smash through enemy lines and Mark V tank, Black Beth. Alright. We record France. Fall 1918. It's late in the war. As winter draws in, the Germans fortify their lines and dare the enemy to come to them. Waves of infantry die crushing against the German concrete. The maps do not change. Heavily armored and well protected, the British Mark V tank is a fearsome war machine. It clears trenches, destroys barbed wire, the tank is a thing can breathe through. On October 17th, British forces prepare a massive assault on the town of Cobrai. With tank support, the Allied command believes a breakthrough is certainty, but the Mark V, read by too fast. I can definitely read that if I wasn't reading it out loud, but I can read while reading it out loud. driver before the war. Or before he served.
Edmund!
Sir.
Townsend.
Come on, you miss all the fun.
That's American. This American for sure.
Is it?
Oh, that's British accent. Actually, it's probably mixed.
I've been looking at your papers.
Don't worry about me, sir. I'm ready to do my bit for King and Country.
Listen, son, you find forward and reverse when you're told you'll do all right for me. Grab those, would you? Come and meet Big Bess. Woman of your dreams.
Oh, yeah. Infiltration of the first tank. Boys. Through mud and blood. Oh, we're driving, alright. Good thing, because I'm sick of gunning. Oh, actually, showing the inside. Oh, is it?
Bloody.
Whoa, no, don't swear.
She does not like it when you swear. Finch.
Edwards.
You've done this before.
Done what before?
Mind your business with manners. Listen, don't worry. She'll look after you, yeah?
All right, boys. This is the big one. Our orders are to punch through the German line, destroying artillery positions as we go. Finch.
Yep, we have armor, though. And guns. Lots of guns. Crank the engine. We get really loud and really smoking.
After that, we'll advance on the French town of Cambrai.
You guys
have been assured there is wine, women, and song.
So you should enjoy that.
Ha, I'm a man, it's wine.
Easy.
Jesus. Are we in safe hands or what, boys?
All right, my lads. Remember, boys, do your jobs. Take care of each other. Big Bess will take care of you.
May the Lord have mercy on our souls.
We get through this together, right, Edwards?
Right, sir.
Full ahead, driver!
Indeed, Ford! Archer's battlefield we should go. In 5 years. Excuse us, going through. That's the trench. There we go. Oh, in third person for this? Yeah, we are. Do we get guns? Ooh.
The damn bird is shitting.
Fall in that manners. Bird's mole.
I'll pluck every feather off that damn.
Easy there. That pigeon could save your life. It's our only line of communication.
This is just like a wireless.
Yes. Starting to get the hang of it.
What'd you do back home?
Drove. A car. I was a chauffeur.
All stop.
This is far enough. Infantry will go on the first whistle.
Then we follow.
Roger that.
Bob, you ever seen anything like this?
I have, I'm sorry to say.
Listen, we're going to cut down the guns up by that windmill.
Hey, thanks for pointing it out.
Give our boys some room.
That's our cue.
Full ahead!
That dipped. Got your frickin' clean mill. We got it. Oh, great. Now, hopefully, this doesn't stall on us or jam or get muddied.
Don't let those deaths be for nothing. Move.
Yep.
I got one of ours. Ice front. Drive.
I got. Can you switch to first person? Just wondering. I can switch to first person. I can switch to camera, but no, I don't think you can switch to first person in the campaign, unfortunately. At least not yet, anyway. Get back, mud.
We're moving slow. Finch, what's the matter?
Engine's fine, sir. It's the mud.
Okay, let's blast from their cover.
Field gun! Move and get clear
shot. Oh, where's field gun? Oh, I see it. Bar. I'm not used to using the Mach 5, period. Oh, yeah, sure. Oh, that's cute. That, you know, oh, lost the tank. You know how much these green things cost? Actually, they're dirt cheap, but still. Burk. Oh, yes, let's repair real quick. It's like war thunder, oh great. You have a machine gun, really. Now, in multiplayer, the driver only gets to control the front gun. There you go. Which is made for like balancing purposes, as well as we got coaxials. Use them, or not coaxials, but these. Oh, there's an anti-tank grenade. Oh, it's on top of us. That's what I get for being. That's what the thing gets for being so big. Which, by the way, this thing's as big as an Abrams. Well, as long as it anyway. It's much thinner though. I'm already in one Abrams tank. Guns, you're out of cover. Man, so this is where this is what the War Wound stuff was. And the campaign's amazing so far. Hello! I love a good match. Clean out all the German guns. And that gun and move. We don't leave our boys. Turn back. But the battlefield has always had this. Oh, we're hitting the windmill. The battlefield has always had this method. Oh, you guys. Battlefield has always had this methodology of. If you're playing campaign, if there's multiple people in the tank with you, you get special benefits. They've been doing this since at least Battle for Vietnam 2, in which basically the Abrams had all the upgrades you could get in the game. This was before Abrams having zoom, unless you physically needed to have zoom. Oh, that went just through the shield. Where are these guns? But yeah, but since we're fully crewed, you got full control of the tank.
Hold them, keep them suppressed.
All right, we got a capture. I just didn't play which. And then, forward.
Now we take the next trench line.
Jitter is doing its job against us, but we're going to do its job. We're going to do our job against everything else. Alright, for certain. Trench. I'm pretty sure we'll get stuck in the trench if I do it any other way. Yeah, maybe a little bit more generous and.
Down.
Okay, that guy's gone. Any field guns? Yes.
Keep your eyes peeled for more of those guns, lads.
Yep. Oh, hello. Oh, let's use our buttons for what they're actually used for. Alright, moving on. Oh, field gun. Aim. Gotcha, thanks for flinging out. Other side! That's the wrong side. There you go. Remember, I don't have a turret. I have two guns on the sides. Okay, this guy? Rush your tank. I wonder if he even knows what a tank is. I'm pretty sure he may because this is a Mark V, not a Mark I. Yep. Forward.
We're heading for the ruins, clearing a path for the infantry. What's that gun?
Oh, that's it. That was a mess. Aside. Oh.
One less field gun to worry about, boys.
I wonder if this guy's trying. I wonder if I can go through this. Yeah, I can. Where's this guy? I mean, since the fact that they have field guns pointed at us, I would say that, yeah, they are prepared for tanks. The thing about World War I is they weren't prepared, you know, they weren't prepared for tanks. Oh. So, basically, they make their artillery's point down if they saw a tank coming. So, artillery's point down, which means they knew we were coming. Oh, hello.
Stay focused, guys.
Should I give the bird some mouth? He's having a riot to do.
Don't mess with a pigeon, Pritchard. That's our only link back to headquarters.
Edwards, how about you? Do you need a drink to steady your hands?
No, I don't drink. Save the fun and games for when we arrive at Cambrai, boys.
Watch the tank, guys. Watch it. Oh, shoot it. Oh, great. I'm actually using cover.
I've
already lost the engine. Oh, great. Oh, heavy tank!
That's him incoming!
It is bigger gun than us. But I only has one of them. I can use that to our advantage if I can actually maneuver. Also, I don't know if we're faster than it or not. Because, like I was saying, this thing only goes this fast. This actually is pretty fast for what I think actually went, which was 5 miles an hour. So, yeah.
One more dart.
Okay, pull this up real quick. While we're here. And then go over for the heavy. Heavy does not expect. It's not expecting to come from this angle, actually, yes, it is. It's not dumb. Can we sit here? Oh, we might be able to sit here. Maybe. Maybe a little high. Are you damaged to the blasted thing? I don't know what I should do to turn! Pointing direction? Yeah, pointing direction, oh my word. I'm so used to Halo maneuver. How you maneuver in Halo. All the guys that are gray. Brown is our color. Turn. Actually, repair, we're good. Guys, don't rush the flag until we are bunch of all repaired. Oh, you still gotta get the infantry down. Get it back up and then engage everything again. Alright, real forward.
Good work, son. Push forward.
Man, this is used. I mean, this thing's made out of machine guns as well. There's female versions of these things. This is a male tank. Female versions have two machine guns in the spawn as opposed to one gigantic gun. It's 2-1 cannon. Okay, switching over to cannon. Hello. He was very first coming from over here. Oh, great. That's an old grenade, I think. Alright, taking the flag again. They're falling back, I wonder why. Hopefully it's because of us. And not like a massive artillery. And hopefully not a massive artillery barrage or, you know, gas.
We need to move on! Great work, lads! Time to move on!
Alright, sorry, guy. Yeah. Oh, great. Oh no. Oh, orange is down. How'd he get there?
You good? You sure?
Oh. Oh great, grab his wrench. Yep. We're playing battlefield. Oh, there's a hammer in this game, as well as a wrench. Coming! You'll see, coming in. Yep. Must avenge him. Alright, and he should just. Oh, great. I know, you can. Thank you for spotting, Commander. Good thing you missed that shot. I should reverse more. So another one. Oh, I see it. You can flush these blasted things. Okay, let's go this way. No, this guy, there we go. Tank controls are so weird in this game. I mean, they're necessarily weird because, well, tanks are so weird. And they wanted to make it a little bit easier on people to use these things, so yeah. Married up the thing, using our tracks for their purpose. Kinda. It works for that too. Works for going up and down inclines as well, going up and down trenches, because my trenches is just a flat incline. Oh, you want to get that gun again? I don't think so. Let's go, everyone get that gun again. break their houses. Someone's gonna have to pay for it. It's gonna be the Germans, but still. Maybe paying for it into the 2000s.
Hurry with that field gun.
Ah, terrorists! Oh! York fire terrorists, but now let's go up there, terrorists. Get in the middle. Got it, terrorists destroyed. That was kind of easy. What did you say,
John? Let's fight the rest!
But, I guess spoiler, but at the transfer size, all the Emerald powers got together, or whatever the Allies called themselves back then. Like the pre-Allies call themselves. And then they got together. I talked about how Germany, Austria, Hungary should pay for the war in life. Why did that have an off day? I don't care. It's animation. Okay, that's be more so collected than that. That's an off day. They should not have that. They definitely should not have that. I'm pretty sure they should not have that. Unless it's some sort of Austria-Hungary thing. Oh, we are running low enough. Other side of the side. Oh, these are different cameras too. I just noticed that. We need to get some cover. We have a gun in the back. Yeah, this will stay low morale. We're almost below disintegrating for the fact that I'm running away in a tank. Okay, start repairing. Can I shoot and repair? Come on, give me an LMG guy! Oh, I gotta say the LMG guy. Too late. I'm running a gun. But long story short, the Allies said, you know what, Germany? You gotta pay us a ton of money. You can pay us in small amounts or whatever you can pay, and basically it turned out that Germany, yes, even the Federal Republic of Germany, was paying the Allied powers for damages caused by the war, both obviously this, yeah, obviously this, and vehicles, machinery, and men. Because back in World War I, they put prices on men's lives, at least when it comes to, down to the, at least when it comes down to having the enemy pay for it. Anyway, so yeah, which I think they stopped paying, I think the last payment was like in 2002, almost a century after the war. Which, after World War I, Germany was in such a mess, which led the Nazis, which basically gave the Nazis some foothold to gain power. And, blame the Jews and stuff like that. Oh, he's down. Oh, is that still done? Indeed, I forgot. I forgot they're on wheels. They can turn as far as they want. Oh, that could be bad. It was field. There you are. Guns. Kill shows no one firing these guns though. Okay, shield our guys. Watch my towards enemy.
Keep pushing on, lads. We've soon taken this spot.
That's a grenade. I don't think this would be anything. Big bullies for me. Alright. Our response was stuck. Oh, here comes the plane. Wasn't big enough distraction, unfortunately. The pod got okay away, and they got parachutes, right. You don't know. World War I, no one used parachutes. They weren't really invented either. Suck on this!
Target destroyed!
Oh, what happened there? Did the villain blow up or what? Oh yeah, it did. Now, previously in Battlefield games, you could technically repair inside vehicles if you can get your repair tool out. It's an on-off feature in Battlefield games where you could get your repair tool out and start repairing the vehicle if you could, get it out and actually repair, like wall, floor, or roof of a vehicle. Nope, I'm not going this way because I'll get stuck. Okay. Crush it, Dillery. Good or not? Okay. Alright, moving. Maybe we can just get out, can't we? We can just get out, okay, if we want to. If you want to do this mission just all by yourself, I guess you can. I would want to try it. That'd be cool. That'd be interesting. Okay, then we'll get a machine gun.
There's a field gun!
Oh, well, we're trying to... Can't do that much. No gun. Bunker. We're still pushing up. Yeah, we're still pushing up. This is a huge map, and very much Trench Warfare.
Field gun! Go!
Okay, when bunkers go, they go. That's good to know. Oh, come on. Oh, heavy tank! Fire! Get behind the bunker! Okay, you still hit me? He would if he could. Okay, I want to turn, which is push in. I want to push bottom right. Yes. There we go. It's picking the wrong gun. Still got it though. Yep, we did. We didn't take any damage, I don't think. Bridge, good thing we're not surviving. Excuse me, coming through. I have to break all your defense. I gotta break all your cover though. We're doing arrows to bridge, we're gonna blow it up. Jeez, we can't. It's gonna get right in his face. I'm stuck. Other side! Oh, that's good. Got it. Hopefully, they don't try to defect direct fire the artillery. Why are you trying to shoot us through the hatches, or are you just trying to annoy us? Oh, look at this mud. Oh, wow. Oh great. Oh great, they're boarding. Yeah, if it can go off for next to your ear in close space like that. Careful. They'll over you. There you go. Hopefully don't shoot the pigeon. People did do that. Oh. The pigeon. First time you ever get to control an animal in Battlefield. Oh wow. I believe there was wireless, but apparently they can't put them in tanks. That's usually a ship or indoor headquarters thing. And even then, they usually use telegraph wires. That's not good. When you roll the pigeon, that can't be good. Yellow sidetrack, my bad. Just follow the pulsating light. Pigeon knows what it's doing. Get loaded, come on, get through the tanks. In the offensive.
Here it comes, boys. Nice serving with your lads.
If he doesn't, but at least not to get you close. There you go. They did his job. They had good. Well, they had as good aim as you could possibly get in this at this time period.
You have the look of the devil, Townsend. Is that right? All we got out here is blind orders and chance. Which you'll do for us first, you reckon?
I'm sick of your whip, McManus.
Aye, aye, sir.
It will start it up.
Oh, come on.
Give
oh, great.
Us a break. Give us a break. Come on. Ah, come on, miss. Come on. Stop. Stop, Big Miss. Stop. Stop. It stopped. Are you just going to stand there?
Try again. There we go.
Can't see more than 20 yards.
We're pushing through. Edwards, I'll drive. You jump out and scout ahead.
Don't be a hero, lad. Just do your job.
Yep. I can always do both, you know. Oh, they give me this thing.
Let's all get through in one piece, eh? If you get into trouble, we'll be right behind you, lad.
Was on the mission? No, I don't think so. Well, let's find out.